82-year-old Charlie Atkinson is lucky to be alive.
Ambulance took him to Mass General, and he was admitted to the regular floor. And that first night, they said, we need to put in a breathing tube. If you have a breathing tube, you also then have to have the feeding tube as well.
5 years ago, a mosquito bite left him with a severe case of West Nile virus.
I think the odds were against Charlie. Charlie was a really healthy guy who got West Nile virus that resulted in this polio-like paralysis. If we talk about just numbers of people who look like Charlie, who need the tracheostomy tube because they can't get off the ventilator, of these people, about half will die. These are the people who only 1 in 10 will be home and independent in a year.
After 5 weeks, Charlie was moved from Mass General to Spalding Rehab in Cambridge. There was progress, and there were setbacks.
The idea that I'd ever go home was a fervent hope and a distant dream, but not a possibility. The going home was a constant thing, and how important it was to get right back here.
For a time, doctors at Spalding Rehab felt Charlie's progress had plateaued. They gave Jeanette the bad news. It was time to start looking for a nursing home.
We looked at nursing homes. The only one that would take Charlie with the ventilator and the needs that he had was west of Worcester. And if he had been in that type of sort of limbo, it wouldn't have been much of a life.
Maybe it's just looking at it now. There certainly is a point where you have to call it quits. And the idea of keeping people in warehouses in a state like I was for the rest of my life, it would not have been worth living. And I hope I had the guts to call it quits.
But when faced with that choice,
they brought me a form to sign with a DNR, do not resuscitate. And it's one of those things that theoretically, I really believe in that. But when it came time to making a decision, I thought long and hard about that and decided not to sign it.
There were 4 times when Charlie stopped breathing, twice at Spalding and twice at home.
Modern medicine does have all these interventions, so there's a lot at your disposal to keep people going, but how do you initiate this conversation about what's best? Who gets to make that choice?
To know what the right thing is to do for somebody, you need to ask. Faced with similar situations, people are going to have very different responses, and our goal is to help them get to whatever life they would find acceptable given their medical realities. And sometimes that's not the same decisions we would make. And that's okay, too.
During that whole time, even though I thought it was quite possible that Charlie could die, it wasn't something that I dwelt on at all. There was a very day-to-day feeling about it, and it was an achievement of that day, perhaps to stand on the parallel bars, that was a red letter day, or a day that was a step back if he needed more time on the vent or couldn't sit up for a long time. It was much more a day-to-day thing.
As the days turned into months, Charlie Atkinson began improving. 14 months after that mosquito bite, Charlie Atkinson left Spalding Rehab, his support and care now in the hands of his dedicated wife.
When Charlie came home, I would never, ever, ever want to relive those. The responsibility, the lack of knowledge, the limited training that we got, the calls to the ambulance to go make emergency trips to Mass General. We were so unprepared for looking after that serious level, and I hadn't had a clue. We had some very nice times, but oh my gosh, the responsibility of that was really difficult. It was really bad.
I think I can take a little walk on the wild side.
But the Atkinson family got through it, and Charlie is improving daily.
He was unlucky to get West Nile the way he did, but lucky that he slowly started to improve, and lucky that he has amazing sort of reserve, just personal reserve, where he loves being alive. He is dedicated to his recovery. He celebrates every gain that he makes, and in his early 80s now, he has tons of plans for the future. He is the 1 in 10.
Crawling out of that and seeing the possibility of getting better every day. I'm walking at 2 miles an hour. I'm now walking without a cane. I'm planning to be on the tennis court in July.
Wow, that's just great. Mm-hmm. And Charlie just celebrated his 60th college reunion from Harvard.
Yeah, and that was his goal. One of his goals was to get there and attend all the events. He was able to do that, even have a dance with his wife, Jeanette, which was lovely. And being goal-oriented really has helped him. As you heard throughout the piece, he was always setting goals for himself and reaching those goals, and that really helped him to move forward.
That's smart. Up next, a bright future changes with one night of partying.